Non-Americans, what is something you find strange or different about American culture? How friendly Americans are allowed to be. In Britain, talking to strangers is seriously weird except in the proper social context. And if you're forced into it, it's still weird to talk about things other than the weather and how crap David Cameron is and such. For all the crap we catch abroad, I've heard from a lot of non-Americans that it's surprising how friendly most of us are. I mean, it's definitely regional in the States. I'm Texan, for example, but I love meeting other people, even other Americans traveling abroad. It's just fun to have a chat every now and then. The whole "sue the crap out of them" really confuses me. I understand that in some cases, dentist doctor did a botched job. I've seen a couple of threads on Reddit though where someone says that their arm was broken during a school fight. Just something stupid happening between silly kids, and the top response will be encouraging them to sue. I really don't understand that. The same goes when it was an obvious accident with no malicious intent. Maybe I'm just a naive Australian, but suing for something like that just seems really excessive. Usually those involved would help cover the cost. Our healthcare is expensive. How sports is integrated into college university. I don't see how sports teams and games are relevant to education. The fact that someone can get a football, basketball or cheerleading scholarship is amusing and bizarre. It's a huge money maker for the bigger schools. I have to admit though, in theory I don't see why having athletics at university level is a bad thing. It's just the inevitable politics and corruption behind it that are bad. Your obsession with college this and college that, football and basketball, also how you have to apply for heaps of different universities and make a huge fuss on where you are accepted or not, and how much emphasis on being successful equals going to Harvard or MIT. Americans are so enthusiastic about everything. It's a breath of fresh air sometimes when I'm surrounded by and am a cynical British citizen. What the blazes is homecoming and why is it called that? I've had three different people try to explain it to me and I'm none the wiser. It's a high school thing. When the football team plays their last game on their field, as opposed to playing at another team school, it's called homecoming and there's usually a homecoming dance to celebrate school pride. I've always thought it was kind of silly. I've never understood the whole having to tip being so important. Also, the Pledge of Allegiance seems somewhat cultish. You have to tip because, in nearly all cases, the pittance we food service people make and wages goes entirely to state and federal taxes. Even if it didn't, we'd still only make about $2 HR. Why is the legal drinking age 21? Seriously, I live in Canada where it is 19 and I find that to be a little too much. How can you justify someone being able to vote for 3 years but not able to buy beer? The instinctive and what appears to be knee-jerk reaction to a national health service, or any type of socialized medicine. It's not the world's best system, but it's got to be better than the insane insurance system America has, and if people want to go private, they still can. Many Americans want a universal healthcare system. How they communicate. I have an American friend, I am Guatemalan, that has email fights with her parents and brother, as in Ray, mom is being crazy FWD to brother dad and mom etc etc. Also, kids and their sense of entitlement. I got beat the frick up if I acted like a little C. These kids just get their way. The extreme capitalistic government. Finland is an excellent example of a mixed capitalist socialist economy, and where aren't any commies. Trust me. Okay, comrade. Why does no one know how to drive a manual car? Over here, UK, most people learn in a manual and then very few people ever switch to an automatic car. It just seems silly. If you have a license for an automatic here, then you can only drive an automatic car. With manual you can drive both. It's hard to eat a burger and drive a manual at the same time. Frick, not this again. Every fricking week. Let me guess. 1. Healthcare. 2. Guns. 3. Tipping. 4. Taxes. 5. Military. So help me. Last time these was a discussion on how it is odd that Americans love freedom too much. Like, not ironic freedom but actual liberty and what was so great about it. These are legit issues. But 1. We do this every freaking week. And 2. It's never a healthy discussion but anti-American BS fueled by foreigners who refuse to admit the issues on their own end. Come on, Reddit, you're better than this. Well, maybe not. First one I seen. Thanks for the repost, D. I went to NYC this summer with my cousin, and we found that the people there always talk very loud, on the phone in the subway, in restaurants, on the streets, even to say hello to each other it was all screams and yelling. We were under the impression that yelling was the primary communication mode. After a week, we were glad to go home and eating at restaurants where we can talk without yelling to cover the sound of other patrons. Sorry for my poor grammar, English is not my native language. New Yorkers allowed. Embalming. I thought it was just for mummies and communist dictators. It was big surprise that embalming is widely used in today's North America. I think it stems from our deeply seated fear of the restless dead. Every American is taught in grade school that the only way to prevent a corpse's inevitable reanimation is to replace all of the body's fluids with safe, patriotic formaldehyde. Things we Americans hate, too. Seriously, though, came to this thread looking for enlightenment in social norms we have, strange customs, etc. All I see is reiteration of American arguments and complaints. Why do you make heroes out of idiots? In my country, South Africa, if someone does something morally reprehensible, like beating a woman, looking at you Chris Brown, we bury them in a hole of shame. Why are you so quick to forgive and forget? Why are TV shows made about people with such vapid personalities? Jersey Shore, anything by Paris Hilton, Real Housewives of Who the Frick Cares, The Hills etc. that offer nothing to the benefit of art, culture or even humanity, yet they become idolized like gods among ants. 1. Plenty of Americans hate Chris Brown. 2. $$$$, which is why other nations have been adopting the reality show model. Saying yaha instead of you're welcome. I'm Canadian, and yes, it's true, we generally say please, thank you, and you're welcome. I'm speaking mostly about the East Coast and Midwest, but I don't understand the attitude. When I go down to the States to, say, a Dunkin' Donuts and order a coffee, I will say thank you every time when they hand me my coffee. I'd say 8 out of 10 times, my expression of gratitude is met with a slightly annoyed response of yaha. The other 2 times I don't get an answer at all. It just comes off as so negative to me. I don't understand why people can't just say thank you or you're welcome. I don't understand it, either, and I'm from the Midwest. Always say please and thank you and you're welcome. Taco Bell. All I ever hear about that place is how their food sends people running to the restroom in short order, yet everyone still goes back. Why? I'm an American and I love my country, but after living abroad for a few years I'm astounded by how uncultured and unsophisticated Americans are. I've met Bedouin, pickpockets, street urchins and gypsies who all have been more cultured, proud and sophisticated than the wealthiest Americans I've met over the years. That's just my observation, but it's really sad to me that kind of generally speaking, Americans are pretty freaking rough-hewn cowboys and crap. It's embarrassing. Well, I'm a little late, but I find the driving culture to be extremely strange. I'm staying with friends and they said we're too tired to cook. Let's go out for dinner, a 30 minutes drive away. Back in Sydney, driving more than 5 minutes meant I was going somewhere fancy. Another friend drove 3 hours to spend a day with me in New Jersey, and they thought nothing of it, as if it was a normal occurrence. No one seems to want to catch trains, and outside of the main metro areas, there is no way to get to the train station besides a car. When I mention that I live in the Sydney suburbs, but never drive to uni, work or the shops, everyone stares at me quite blankly. I think the biggest culture shock for me when I started meeting more Americans was the way they, you, build their relationships in general. Where I'm from, we're polite but a little distant at first, and then as we get to know a person, we get friendlier and a lot more open. When I was 16 I went on a program that had a really big American group. And at first I thought they were the best people I'd ever met because of how outgoing and nice they all seemed. However, most of those friends I thought I'd made didn't really think of me as a friend, and weren't really that interested in getting any closer to me. It took a little longer than I'd like to admit to realize that, and it actually sucks. I do have a bunch of American friends now, though, but I still find it weird the way they treat people when they first meet them. that in some states, tax is not included in the retail price. I have no idea why one would come up with that or why it persists. I don't think it's included in any state. Every state has a different percentage for sales tax, and in some states it even varies by city region. Each store would have to print tons of custom signs to include the tax. Your crap adverts. Whenever I watched The Apprentice and the Tusks had people making commercials, I thought, dang, these are bad. Then I saw what commercials are on TV, and they were the same. In your face, no nuance, just amateurish. This isn't meant to be an America bashing thing, but I really don't understand the concept that guns equals safety. I mean, if we were on a shooting range and I pointed a loaded weapon at you, you would probably freak out and say never point your gun at someone. It's so dangerous. But Americans are fine with having these things in their homes, and rely on the gun to keep them safe in dangerous situations. Egg burglaries. Whereas it just seems like it adds a whole new element of danger and unpredictability to me. A gun is literally a machine designed to kill living things. Bullets are designed to penetrate flesh. It blows my mind that people carry these things or keep them in their own homes. The complete ignorance of many Americans to the outside world. That many Americans cannot see why other nations do not want to be American. Why immigration seems to be such an enormous political issue. The US is a nation of immigrants. Why do so many people get so angry about letting anyone else in? Guns, violence, and a bit of gore. Okay. Show healthy woman's breast, or a bare butt. No can do. Even casual swearing is a no-no. I find it strange when people will think it's funny that you're still a virgin at 17, but in my country, people will already assume you're S if they just heard you lost your virginity at the same age. Tipping. Everybody is dying for a tip all the time. Does nobody get paid enough? Like I sort of get in restaurants. We leave tips here too. The UK, although I should say that I've noticed it becoming more and more popular in the past decade, and I put that down to American culture as well. TV shows and films and whatnot. But I find anytime I visit the States, a lot of people working in the service industry feel they're due a tip for whatever it is they do. I wouldn't mind so much if it didn't totally affect the way they treated me. They're almost overly nice in the hopes that you'll tip them, to the point of being annoying. And then if you don't, the tone totally changes, and I've had several occasions where they're angry to the point of providing a really bad service. I had an experience with my dad where he didn't tip a delivery guy enough. I think it was like a keep the change kind of thing rather than a proper tip, who then point blank refused to leave until we gave him money. We had enough for the food, and a tiny bit more that we gave him, and nothing else. Anyway, he was a dong about it, but now I just tip like everyone else in the States. Still find it really odd as a cultural thing though. I don't want this to come across as rude or mean or anything, I just find it weird. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.